Welcome friends and subscribers to my YouTube channel. Today's video is about IUI in a case of low ovarian reserve. Today's video is a part of our video playlist on low AMH. You must have seen the previous two videos. If you have not, do check them out. In the first video, I have covered AMH and the basics of AMH. Whereas in the second video, I have talked in detail about IVF and the different IVF protocols which may be used in a case of low AMH. Today's video is a very interesting one that discusses about IUI, that is intrauterine insemination, in a couple in which the wife has low AMH. Now, let me tell you right at the start of the video that IUI is not a very good treatment as far as a woman with low AMH is concerned. There are various reasons why IUI is not a good treatment in these couples. Let me start with that. So what happens when we do an IUI is we stimulate the lady's ovaries, produce eggs, and we inseminate the lady's uterus with the man's sperms. Now, if you get a treatment success from IUI, there's nothing like it. However, even in a woman with normal egg count and normal ovarian reserve, we may require up to 3 or 4 or even more IUIs to produce a result. So in a lady who has extremely low number of oocytes, just imagine how many IUIs we may require to do. However, at the same time, IUI does have a small role to play, and that's why I have made this video. Also, another thing that happens is, in case IUI fails, we never know why it failed. We never know, was it because of the lady's egg quality and egg quantity, or is it because of some sperm or male related factor? Is it some uterine factor, or is it any tubal factor? The doctor never comes to know about this, because in IUI you anyways don't understand this. The answer to all these questions can only come in IVF. Hence, I always consider that IVF is the only treatment that should be recommended, or rather ideally recommended, in a couple who is having low ovarian reserve. Now let me tell you how IUI has its role. I feel IUI can be performed only in those ladies or those specific couples who fit a certain criteria. One of the important criteria is it has to be a case of secondary infertility. That too, the couple should already be having a live birth, and that too a healthy, non-handicapped child. If at all the couple does not have a healthy child with them and they are very keen on conception, IVF is the only way ahead. Do not waste time doing IUIs. However, if the couple just wants to take a chance and does not want to spend a lot on IVF or has limited financial resources, I would say IUI is one of the very good methods that you can go ahead. So let me be very clear, IUI in low ovarian reserve is only for those couples who already have a healthy child at home and is trying to conceive the second or their third child. And it is not for those couples who do not have a live birth or have previous miscarriages and do not have any live birth or a healthy child at home. Let me be very clear about that. So what sort of an IUI you should be going ahead with? I would say the only type of IUI that you should be aiming is a super ovulated IUI. A super ovulated IUI is an IUI that is done with gonadotropins. Definitely, you can use clomiphene citrate or letrozole as one of the adjuncts for the ovarian stimulation. However, you do require the benefits that a gonadotropin can give you. Also, maybe a higher dose of gonadotropins may be required in couples who have low ovarian reserve. Maybe around 1 to 2 ampoules per day on a daily injection basis just like IVF may be required in these couples. So today's video is a very short video because there is not a very large role that IUI plays in a couple with low ovarian reserve. It is meant for only a small spectrum of people, that is ladies who are already having a child at home. I hope today's video was educational to you. Do see the entire video series on AMH. Do remember to like the video in case you find it educational, and do remember to subscribe by pressing the subscribe button below. The next video is a very interesting video on the topic of low AMH, where I am going to cover the different financial aspects of low AMH treatment and how you have to strategize when you are affected with low AMH and when you also at the same time have limited financial resources. So do see all the playlists till the end. Thank you.